What's up, Panthers, and happy Friday. We're almost at the end of the school year, so let's finish strong. And now into the news. This mock trial team is sponsoring a food drive by the Conejo Valley Mana Food Bank. The last day to donate is June 4th, and you can donate right at our school. It's a great way to help our community during this time. With all this extra time, many of us have learned new skills or even try improving old skills. Angel took a look into one of these students in particular and what they're doing to make the most out of this extra time that we have. Take it away, Angel.
Being part of a band requires the work of multiple people in order to function. Although the audience gets one final product, it is necessary for each member to pull their own weight. The skills that are required by each individual that lead to the band performing at a very high level are achieved not by one moment or a specific time, but it is rather an ongoing process that is refined every single day.
I normally practice around 4 or 5 hours a day, just about every day, and I wake up and I eat breakfast, and then I practice for a couple hours, maybe play 30, 45 minutes in the middle of the day, and then I'll practice for like an hour and a half before I go to sleep. And if I can't sleep, then I put a silent mute in and practice in the early hours of the morning. I do lots of different exercises. There are like 3 main categories. There are lip slurs, which focuses on the facial muscles. I do technical studies, which are really good for your fingers, so getting around the instrument. And then I also do long tones, which aren't as hard or complicated as the lip slurs or the technical exercises, but they help to improve my tone. This quarantine is great because I'm finding more ways to stretch myself musically. It's hard to keep myself motivated during this time, I'll admit. But I really try to think of the trumpet player I want to be when this is over. When I go to school, I want to show up and, you know, make the best impression of myself. You know, this is the time where I can either work really hard and better myself and come out of quarantine so much better than I went in, or I'm going to like kind of come out okay because I play my horn a little bit, but not seriously. I'm a music major at Santa Barbara City College, and I'm minoring in musical theater. So, you know, I don't want to give up playing the trumpet after high school. And many people do, and that's not a problem, but this feels like more of a hobby, or like more than a hobby to me.
Reporting for PTV, I'm Angel Mendoza.
Thanks, Angel. At 7 o'clock tonight, the Newbury Park Dance Team is premiering their live documentary on Twitch TV. If you would like to join, go to twitch.tv/NPHS_dance if you would like to watch the live premiere. Quarantine has affected many things in our daily lives, one of the biggest things being our friendships. Gabe got a chance to interview Mitchell Zager, who explains how he thinks quarantine has affected his relationship so far.
With social distancing being in effect, the friendships of many MPHS students have been affected. However, this does not mean that they are over. Many students, such as Mitchell Zager, have found ways to keep in contact with their friends over the internet. However, quarantine is a big obstacle and is still affecting friendships. Here's how.
I've stayed connected with my friends over quarantine by playing games with them whenever I have any spare time during the day, and it allows me to stay connected with them and catch up and see how they're doing. I think that quarantine has greatly affected my friendships just because we've had to get used to not being able to see each other every day. And we've had to come up with different solutions to keep in contact.
Another topic of interest is, how will quarantine affect friendships?
I think that some relationships will be different once quarantine is over, just because we've gotten so used to talking to each other and communicating without really seeing each other. So it's gonna be a little weird once school comes back. I would say that a lot of my relationships have strengthened over the quarantine, just because there's a lot of time during the day to catch up with people and make sure they're doing all right. And even though we can't obviously go out and hang out with each other. There's still other ways to keep in touch.
Reporting for PTV, I'm Gabe Sanchez.
Well, Panthers, that's all I have for you today. I hope you all have a great day, and remember to finish the school year strong. Later, Panthers.